In this video, you will see a breakdown of the complete process of me making this awesome 3D render for Fortnite map for an ITV show called I'm a Celebrity. If you will have any questions after watching this video, make sure to leave a comment or ask me on my Discord server. Now let's hop into the video. So I've asked my amazing community on Discord and Twitter to ask some questions about certain parts of the render for this video. To not miss posts like this, join my Discord and follow me on other socials. So now let's get to the questions. The first question is from Aspect. He's asking, how you made the environment. So I made the environment by porting it using the UMAP add-on for Blender. The add-on allows you to port Fortnite maps and like the Battle Royale Fortnite map and Fortnite Creative maps, both Creative 1.0 and UEFN maps. It's a bit complicated to use, so I'll not explain everything, but in case you're interested, here are some of the settings, so you can pause and check them. So I ported the whole map. Keep in mind that it doesn't port most of the textures, so like many things come untextured. So this one was textured already, but the tree, this tree, yeah, most of the things were not textured, so I had to texture them manually. So keep that in mind if you want like a good environment. If you're lazy to build something in Blender, you can build it in Fortnite Creative or UFN and then port it. So yeah, that's it. Let's get to the second question by Grier. He said, I'd like to know how you made the lighting, HDRI and sky texture, and god rays. So for the HDRI, I used, let's enable scene world right here. I used this HDRI called, 1 second, here. No Land Midday by Vendraka. You can find the link down below in the description to this HDRI and to the UMAP plugin as well. So yeah, the link to the HDRI and the plugin will be in the description. The strength is 0.6 because I just used it to have this kind of fill light, so 0.6. You see the difference. So the shadows are not that dark. So yeah, that's what I use the HDRIs for. I render with transparent background and then put sky in Photoshop just because I kind of have more control over it. So yeah, that's how I made the environment. And for the sun, I had just a sun lamp here with a pretty orangish, a bit even pinkish color, and pretty saturated because as you can see, the angle here is, like, if we take it like this, the angle here is pretty low, about 30 degrees I would say. So when the sun is on a low angle, you have a bit more saturated warm color, which makes sense, like it happens in real life. I'll not explain all that, but yeah, that's how it works in real life. So that's why I chose this color, played with strength. 15 was the best option here for me. Also, I had a volume for the environment. Also in the world tab with the HDRI, I put principal volume into the volume output right here. Here are the settings if you're interested. Also, here's the color code for the sun and the color code for the fog. And for the god rays, as you probably already noticed, I used a PNG, just a PNG. I played with the settings, obviously. So I put a color ramp, emission, played with the alpha, base color, all that. So yeah, I just faked them. I tried using real god rays, like with volumetrics, but they didn't look that good. And then I tried using, how they called, point lights, no, spot lamps, and have them go here, so they mid-race, but they were not as good as the PNG. And also, using PNGs to replay some of the effects could be better for the performance, so try replacing stuff like that. So that's it for this question. Next one is from Fizzy. Depth of field, god rays, lighting, compositing. So yeah, basically he's wondering how to do everything. Depth of field. Nothing super complicated. Wait, I'll go to this view and disable the scene world. So I had the camera. Depth of field, default settings. I think those are the default ones. And it is focused, as you can see, wait, not here. Focus an object empty. The empty object in my case is this one. So if I move it close to the camera, it focuses, as you can see in this window, it focuses on the camera. If I move it here, it focuses on the character. Basically, it's the point where the camera focuses. So just a very basic camera rig. Next thing, god rays, I already told you. Lighting, nothing super complicated. As I said in my last tutorial, you'll probably see it down in the description or somewhere in this corner, this one, I don't know. So the last tutorial about lighting, this is kind of the basic 3-point lighting setup. So the rim light, the main light, and the fill light is the HDRI. So to explain it even better, the main light is the sun, plus I used this one, this point light, to just make it even brighter to, whoops. So as you can see, it just adds a bit more brightness to the face. So yeah, I decided it looked better like that. Then for the fill light, I used the HDRI. As I already showed you, it's completely black without the HDRI and a bit bluish shadows with the HDRI. So here is the rim light. I have two area lights actually for the rim light, of this color, 9cccff, if you're wondering, and also, okay, a bit different power, so 26, 22, doesn't really matter, just to keep in mind to enable custom, contact shadows sometimes. Here it looked better without contact shadows in my opinion, but yeah, I enabled them here. Make sure to enable them for the sun as well. And here I used custom distance, which allows the light to not go all the way here, but to stop about here for a beautiful rim light. Just play with it. It's not something you need to do on every single render in every scenario. Just play with it and look what looks better. For this character, it's also the main light, but I had two point lights here for the face. And in the final render, I didn't really like it. The character looked too flat, too bright face. Now I would have changed it, but the render is already finished. And yeah, I finished it quite a long time ago. So nothing super complicated here. I just made the face brighter because, as you can see here, if we remove it, it looks too dark. But now I see that even one light was enough. I don't know why I added the second one. So yeah, a little mistake here, but nothing super complicated for the lighting. And the next thing is compositing. So I used only one node, CryptoMat. You'll ask me, probably, Hogni, what's that? What's CryptoMat? And it's actually a really interesting tool. So right here, you can see in the view layer properties, you have the cryptomat and enable object. I have the levels at 6, it's the default value. So enable object. What it lets you do is to let's do it 50% so it runs run this fast. So yeah, as you can see here, I only have the FishStick render right here, which is interesting, right? So if we go here, here is the render. I can select someone else, for example, I don't know, a rock here, and you can see it's there. Wait. Control Z. Okay, like that. So if we preview this, yeah, so it's there. We can get back to previewing this. So look, you can eyedrop. You preview this, you eyedrop, I don't know, the helicopter, for example, and it's here. This helps me in Photoshop, for example, to have control, to have the main character on one layer, everything else on the other one, to have more control over all that. I also tried with the depth map and ambient occlusion, as you can see right here. I tried with this one in Photoshop, but ended up not using it. So yeah, as you can see here, it's a pretty interesting tool that I recommend you all using because it helps a lot. And I've been using it in almost every single render since I found out about this amazing tool. So yeah, that's everything for compositing except for Photoshop part. Next question is from Adam. He's asking how I made the foliage shader. So the foliage shader is pretty interesting. As you can see here, it's not something default. I made my custom shader, which looks like this, and lets the light pass through the leaves like this, which looks really cool. It leaves beautiful shadows and it just looks beautiful. Also, from outside, the trees look very, very smooth, which I also like. So this shader looks like this. I will not show you the full shader setup, or I mean like not go into in-depth explanation, but basically what it does, I have some, I play with color here, then this color goes into diffuse and translucency color, mixes with the, where is it, transparent shader, so it makes the leaves transparent, like the alpha channel, it makes right here, makes this transparent and this is not transparent. And then translucent is this part, so this part is translucent, which allows the light to pass through it. Also, another important setting is subsurface translucency. Also, I have some subsurface on this shader. I made it inside the Fortnite porting shader, as you can see the value here. So yeah, I just made this custom shader for myself, which looks pretty good. I have it on most of the trees, most of the plants right here. And whoops. I have it on the bamboo right here, which looks amazing in my opinion. Like if we compare the, okay, I cannot compare the default material, but if we compare this color and this color, in my opinion, this looks much better. So as the final result, it looks like this. A bit darker, more saturated with ambient occlusion. Yeah, so the ambient occlusion node as well. Yeah, I really like the shader, and it is not that complicated. You just need to play with different settings, experiment, and yeah, just try making something like this until you end up with something you like. That's my best advice on it. So now let's get to the fifth question, which is the last one. It's from Djurko. He said, I would like to know how you made the main sun and environment light. So, as I already mentioned, the environment light is the HDRI with a strength of 0.6, and the link to the HDRI is in the description. And for the sun, right here, this color, strength 15, angle is the default one. What this setting does, if you put the angle to 0, the shadows will be very sharp. If you put, if you make the angle value bigger, then the shadows will be much softer. Also, I have contact shadows enabled, and that's it. So nothing super complicated. This is how I made this render. Also, about faking things, another bonus tip from me. As you can see here in the render, this part of the water looked too dark, so I just added some lights right here, as you can see, to make it a bit brighter. So yeah, that's it for this amazing render. If there is anything you're wondering how I made, then just ask in the comments or in my Discord server, that you can find the link to down below in the description as well. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this, and I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Let me know if you would like to see more videos where I break down the art creation process. I really hoped you enjoyed watching this video and learned something new. If you have any questions, make sure to drop a comment below. I also recommend you join in my Discord server, where you can find cool 3D and 2D assets, chat with other designers, and ask for help. To find out more about lighting, I recommend you to watch this in-depth tutorial about lighting both character and whole scenes. See you!